Welcome back to your free Windows 7 training course. In the previous video, I looked at how to recover lost data files or the complete system if the hard disk were to crash. In some cases, you may install a problematic driver or application that causes the system to become unstable. In most cases, you will simply remove the driver or uninstall the application. In some cases, you may not be able to do this as the application or driver may refuse to uninstall. When this occurs, you could restore your system using a backup, but this is quite a drastic step. Windows 7 offers an alternative to restoring the system and files called System Protection. System Protection has essentially two components. The first saves system settings. This includes the registry and system files and programs. The next part of System Protection is previous versions. This saves changes to documents, including when documents have been deleted. If you're familiar with previous operating systems, you may have seen the previous versions feature called shadow copies or just previous versions. In this video, I will look at restoring the system back to a previous snapshot. In the next video, I will look at how to use System Protection to restore the previous version of your documents. System Protection works by creating a snapshot of the system called a restore point. The restore point can be used to restore the system state or document changes. For example, you could restore the system to a time before you installed a particular piece of software or driver, or restore a file you accidentally deleted. System Protection does not replace the need for regular backups, as it only keeps a copy of changes in a cache. Once the cache is full, the oldest entry is removed to make room for new changes. In order for System Protection to work, it creates a restore point. A restore point is a snapshot of the system at a certain time. System restore points contain registry, system settings, and document changes. If you decide to recover the system to a previously created restore point, the recovery does not affect any documents. Only the system files, registry, and applications are affected. The idea behind system restore points is that if your computer becomes unusable or unstable, the restore point allows you to restore the system back to a time when it was working correctly. Restore points are created automatically by Windows. By default, they are created on startup, midday, or when a significant system change occurs. For example, a significant system change could be when a new piece of software or a Windows update is installed on the computer. When you have installed software before, you may have noticed in the status of the setup a message telling you that a restore point was being created before the install started. Restore points are also automatically created when you install or update device drivers on the system that are not WHQL drivers. WHQL drivers, or Windows Hardware Quality Labs, are drivers that have been tested by Microsoft to ensure that they meet a certain standard. These drivers should not crash the system or cause it to become unstable. Without further ado, I will change to my Windows 7 computer to demonstrate how to use restore points to restore the system state. First of all, open the control panel and then select System and Security. From here, select the option System to bring up the properties for the system. From System, select the option on the left-hand side, System Protection. This will open the system properties and automatically select the System Protection tab. The System Protection tab shows all the current settings used for restore points. If I press the button System Restore, this will launch the System Restore wizard. Once past the welcome screen, I will get a list of all the restore points on the system. At the top is a restore point for Windows Update. When a Windows update is installed, a restore point is automatically created before the update is installed in case the update causes a problem. Of course, you can simply uninstall the update, but a restore point gives you a way of removing the update if something goes wrong and you can't uninstall the update. The next restore points are for software. Most software will create a restore point when it is installed. Older software may not create a restore point. At the bottom, notice that a restore point has been created automatically. If you want to show more restore points, select the option Show More Restore Points. Before you restore your system from a restore point, you may want to know what effect restoring from a restore point will have. If I select the option Scan for Affected Programs, this will show the effects of restoring from this restore point. Even though this restore point was created when Microsoft Office was installed, at the top you can see all the other programs that will be deleted as well. Remember that a restore point will recover your system back to an earlier time. After Microsoft Office was installed, all these programs were installed and will also be removed. At the bottom of the screen is a list of all the drivers that will also be removed if a restore is performed using this restore point. You can see why it is best to use the uninstall option if it is available, but sometimes you may not have a choice. For example, if your system gets heavily infected with malware, you may need to take the restore back to before it was infected. If I go back now to the last screen, I will select a different restore point that will have less of an effect on my system and move on. Once I finish the wizard, I will get a dialog telling me not to interrupt the system restore once it is started. The process takes a while to complete, so I will speed the process up so we don't have to wait. Once done, Windows will reboot and I will be able to log back in again. Windows will give a dialog stating that the system restore was completed and remind me that my documents were not affected. Now that I have restored the system, I will go back into System Protection and have a look at the different settings that can be configured for System Protection. Notice that if I press System Protection again, the wizard will automatically ask if I want to restore the system to an undo restore point. This restore point was automatically created when the system was restored. If you find that restoring the system made things worse, you can always use this restore point to go back to what you had. If I now go back to the properties for system protection, notice that I have an extra hard disk on this system. Currently, system protection is not enabled on this drive. To configure protection, make sure it is selected and press Configure. At the top, the first option is Restore System Settings and Previous Versions of Files. When you modify a document, System Protection can keep a copy of the old document as a previous version. In the next video, I will look at how to recover documents using this feature. The next option configures System Protection to restore only the previous version of files. This effectively stops you from restoring the system to an earlier time if something goes wrong. Remember that restore points save the registry as well. If you are planning on making some risky registry changes, it is a good idea to create a manual restore point before you make the changes. If the drive you are configuring contains only data files, you can select the second option. At the bottom, the amount of space allocated to system protection can be configured. The more space that is allocated, the more revisions of files that can be kept, and also the more restore points that can be kept. This, of course, does reduce the amount of space on the hard disk available for your files and programs. At the bottom, there is a delete button if you find you are out of space and need to reclaim the space quickly. Of course, pressing this button will remove all the data captured by System Protection. If I go back to System Protection, the button Create at the bottom of the screen allows you to manually create a restore point. Once I press it, all I need to do is enter in a description of the restore point and Windows will create a new restore point. If you make registry changes that won't trigger a restore point, it is a good idea to manually create a restore point to recover to if something goes wrong. Let's say that you make some changes to the registry and the system then fails to boot. You can't log into Windows to run the restore wizard, so what do you do? To get around this, you can restore to a restore point using a system repair disk or the Windows DVD. To create a system repair disk, type System Repair in the Start menu and select the option Create a System Repair Disk. The options are the same whether you use a system repair disk or the Windows Setup DVD. In this case, I will reboot the computer and boot from the Windows Setup DVD. When the computer starts up the DVD, it will detect that an OS is already installed. To boot off the DVD, press any key when asked. Otherwise, Windows will boot from the hard disk. If you get this screen, select the Recovery Mode option. The Setup DVD will launch the setup just like you were installing Windows. Once past the Keyboard and Language Selection screen, select the option at the bottom, Repair Your Computer. This will launch the Recovery Options wizard. Your operating system should automatically be detected. If not, you may need to press the Load Drivers button to load additional drivers to detect the hard disk. On the next screen, there are a number of different recovery options to choose from. In this case, I want System Restore. The System Restore wizard will start and is much the same as the wizard in Windows 7. Once you select the restore point that you want to restore to, Windows will confirm which drives will be affected. Once I complete the wizard and confirm I want to continue, the system will be restored to the earlier restore point. As you can see, the process is much the same as running the wizard in Windows 7. The difference to remember is that unlike Windows 7, a restore point will not be created before the system is restored. If something goes wrong, you will not be able to undo the changes. If you only want to restore the system before a recent change that caused your system to become unbootable, this will work quite well. That's it for restore points. In the next video, I will look at how to use system protection to recover documents using previous versions. This has been another free video from ITFreeTraining. For more videos, please see our webpage or YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.